What is bringing hardship to the people of Zimbabwe? It is the people who refuse to change. People who refuse to work with the Constitution. Mr. President, at the beginning of this year, fuel was $1.50 RTG. Today, it's $9.40-something. Our salaries, and I'm not talking about just government, even in the private sector, have not changed. Yes. If there is no way of addressing government, if there is no way of telling government that something is wrong, without fear of imprisonment and criminal liability, how are we going to do that? We have a right to bring the government to account. Yeah. If we are complicit by keeping quiet, by pretending that everything is okay, we are equally guilty. Yeah. In fact, we are worse. Because what we tell the people out there when they go out there, the only way that people will know that we as Senate here across the aisle is by actually saying what is good when it's good and bad when it's bad. I can understand why people would like to protect themselves with laws like this, but I can assure you, Mr. President, nothing will defeat an idea whose time has come. We can carry on debating and we can say how good this is, but at the end of the day, we all know that this bill is primed by fear. Fear of one's own subject. Find out who the criminals are. The criminals can be identified in a way that will make sure that demonstrations can happen peacefully in this country, with the conveners and the police working together, making sure that all the roadblocks can be put so that no one can commit a crime. But threatening people with live bullets from a government that calls itself a democratic government is a shame, Mr. President. So we can keep on talking, Mr. President. I think we are going to go close by close, and when we get to that stage, we will actually point out what is undemocratic about this particular bill. And if we find that because of our numbers we are defeated and the bill goes through, that bill will be challenged in the court and we shall challenge it. Thank you, Mr. President.
I recognize Senator Mnangagwa.